start the drive with Cook. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. A good pickup there of 22. They're going to look to throw. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum.
Here we go.
Big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his pass.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they got across the 50 last time, but fumbled and turned it over, so they'll be looking to have a short-term memory here, Mr. Davis.
Not only a short-term memory, but a whole lot better ball security. Because if they take care of the ball, continue to move it, their chances of scoring some points, they got to feel pretty good about. They thought they had things moving in the right direction last time. Fumbles, they don't just affect you on offense, they affect your overall. Team, because now your defense has to make that stand up.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
All right, here we go.
They'll set up to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end curling in the middle of the field. So it's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch. Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Aaron Donald in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Back to throw here. Man over the middle, and it's complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets us into enemy territory across the 40. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Vikings holding the football. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. They'll look to throw. And Cook has it left side. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it.
It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Come the Vikings. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's got his tight end, Jake Bunt, and he's going to get this inside the 30. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
I know tight ends love this route, because a lot of times they'll fake the block first and get a little bit of space and then come across the middle, because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
Unable to drop the hammer, he just under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36.
Partner, I know the ball security is preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was third and 10 versus third and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
Now let's go!
They'll drop the throw. Going down the middle. It's complete, and he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll look to throw now on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And the Rams got him. They bring him down.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
This offense so far on third down, a perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're looking at a third and goal here. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Yeah, he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us.
And now out comes Minnesota. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the pass.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
A good pick up there of 20 yards. Back to throw now on first down. Complete out right to Jake Buck. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A good pick up there, 26 yards. Again, he'll drop to throw. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. He'll get only 2 there, and it's second and goal.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
The Vikings on third down, a perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is third and goal.
All right, here we go.
They'll set up a throw. It's caught. In the end zone, touchdown, Minnesota. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quick.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. So we've reached halftime here. All right. Starting the third quarter with Cook. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. He'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pickup there, 22. He's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. A good pickup there, 22. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the...
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Vikings. A great effort there. 30 yards. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game. Try and start this drive in the air. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right, safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Holding offense.
Now they were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. Usually going to pick up a holding call.
Let's go!
Looking to throw. On the pressure from the Rams defense.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it, he's a big-time guy you have to block.
They'll look to throw here. Wide open receiver complete. He's got a convoy, and he might be gone. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Find a way to stretch their lead.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the.
Cook as they begin on the ground, and he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage, they've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, this is by Thema Bagley.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Preston Brown leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Well, there's that man again. It's complete. Yeah, they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection. You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. To throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch, but underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
All right, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he's able to find Diggs. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Big hook up there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now. We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Hurry up, here we go.
to throw now on second and 10. Buying time to his left. His throw caught at about the 5. Oh, and the big play's going to get even bigger. His penalty flags are down, and I believe they're going to get a face mask penalty tacked on.
Face mask. Defense.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
And here we go on first and goal. To throw again. That's caught at the 1. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. A great play there. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead. I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time. Looking at it. Field strike, they'll look to throw. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. That one goes for 24 yards. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. That one looks like he'll throw here. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. They have the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
Fourth quarter now in Dallas, and really pouring it on now in the Cowboys. Dak Prescott, 3 touchdown passes to help lead the way. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Second down now after the pass completion.
Single, single, slot, slot. Hey, you're on an island over there. Hurry up, here we go.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. He'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. And partner, this first week,